and welcome to KSUL Santana News. I'm Parker Bartain.
And I'm Bree Cole.
So Bree, I hear we had our assembly about homecoming this week.
Yes, we did, and we have a phenomenal interview with our returning homecoming king. Let's roll the clip.
Angelo, how are you doing, Matt?
Very good, how are you?
Bang bang.
I'm good. So, why are you here today?
I'm here basically to kind of pass the torch on to that next generation of Sultan scholars and, you know, just to celebrate, you know, the past years and, you know, the future years. So it's really good to be back.
All right. How is this important to you?
It's important to me because, you know, it's tradition. You know, we always, you know, focus on the tradition here at Santana, a very rich history. And, you know, we're here today to celebrate that. And that's why it's important, you know.
That's spectacular. It's good to know we have a Sultan here that loves his family. All right. What do you think of homecoming court this year? Do you have any favorites?
You know, I can't pick favorites, but it's a really strong class this year. I'm really happy that so many great candidates are out there. It's a big deal, so I'm very pleased with the crop this year.
Thank you. Thank you for your time.
Thank you so much.
I'm Angelo. How are you doing, Matt?
And we're back.
Yes, we are, and it's good to see how much our Sultan family means to each other.
Speaking of family, we're actually beginning some new members soon.
What do you mean?
This year, the Australian Exchange students are here, and we have an interview with the teacher in charge.
Great. Let's play the clip.
Bartain with KSUL News, and this is Senor Lullivier of Room 704. How are you doing today?
Terrific. Thanks.
No problem. Today we're going to be asking you about the Australian program, because you are the head, basically leader of it all. What is it really about, and what is it for?
So it's a really cool international program where students in Australia, it's their summer there, come here to visit, to meet Americans, real life, true Americans, and do a lot of sightseeing. So they land in LA, they go up to San Francisco, but their favorite part year in, year out is coming down to San Diego, beautiful Santee, and being a part of the lives of many here that go to our school. And so we match these international students that come from Australia with families here that are able to do it.
Awesome. It's crazy to think they're already on summer right now. I'm jealous. Are we still looking for any houses for these foreign exchange students?
Awesome. So there's 22 coming on January 4th. We have exactly two ladies that are available. And when I say ladies, I mean teachers, a 29-year-old and a 30-year-old that are coming with their group as chaperones. We are going to have two students coming, two that are still available. We have a lot coming, but two that are available, female students that are available, and two male students. So we have six total, two chaperones, two females, and two males.
Awesome. And finally, one more question. What can students get out of hosting these Australians?
Awesome. That's a great question. So it's in, what we find year in, year out is this international friendship is started that carries on for years and years. We've had students now that go and see their Australian in Australia, which is always awesome. You go there and stay for free and continue on with the friendship. It's just a great way to, you know, open up the blinders. Sometimes we get into this, you know, mindset of, you know, what we do is the only way to do things, and we get to kind of expose ourselves to different thought and different people and different ways of being, and just kind of see the world through a different light. And so that's truly the end of the day what this is all about, exposing our kids to just different people and different thought.
Awesome. Thank you, Senor. This is Park Bartain with KSUL. Back to the studio.
And we're back. And if you need any information regarding the Australians and the housing program, talk to Senor Lullivier in room 704.
All right. Well, let's get into some Sultan sports.
Yes. We have a pretty speedy interview with cross country. Let's play it back.
Hi, I'm Hunter Young here with KSUL News, and I have Jake Rudolph with me. Now, Jake, what made you get into cross country?
I needed my PE credits, and they didn't kick off the team, and I also needed some conditioning for track.
Nice. What's the longest distance you've ran in a competition?
A 5K, so 3.1 miles.
Now, how many miles do you run a day for practice, like conditioning and stuff like that?
At least six.
That's interesting. Okay, I'm Hunter Young here with KSUL News. Back to you in the studio.
All right, and we're back. And that's all we have for the day. Tune in here next time on KSUL.
But don't forget, next week is Spirit Week, so make sure you dress up all the days. Flyers are set around the campus to show you what each day is. I'm Parker Bartain.
And I'm Bree Cole.
Sultaning off.
Parker!